Welcome to the Bell Historical Collection.
Ladies and gentlemen, on Saturday at midnight, your new dial telephone will be placed in service, and I know you will be pleased.
Today, I'm in a super special place, super top secret place. I can't even tell you where we are. In fact, okay, I can tell you one thing. We're somewhere in Montreal. Come on, because there's a ton of stuff to discover here, and I can't wait for us to see it all together. Follow me. One of the very first telephones solved an issue that I'm sure that you guys still have to this day. Isn't it awful when you talk at the same time as the person that you're talking to? Well, this was only one piece, and so you had to listen and then talk. Something that I think today would be pretty useful. Oh my God, this is so cool. This would have been a typical phone at the end of the 1800s. Fairly simple. This here to listen, and then you would talk through here. And so back then, if you were like average height like me, 5'10", you would have to get like this to talk on the phone. And then if the phone call is a bit too long, this is really, really cool. A little armrest. There you go. This magneto telephone was one of the first phones to be rented out by the company. An ingenious Bell employee, Mr. Arthur Sampson Barwick, invented a wall-mounted armrest that proved extremely useful for customers who wanted to be comfortable while having long conversations. Okay, you gotta see this. This is really cool. This is a phone book from 1972, right? Toronto, normal phone book, the way that we used to have them at home. And this here is one of the very first phone books from 1879. Before the baby boom, after the baby boom. Any questions? Yeah, so it's the birds and the bees, and
soon after you have dialed a number, you will usually hear this tone.
Whoa, this is heavy. So, how does this work? And then, okay, so you would listen here, talk here, and this was like a cordless phone. This was for the operators, so that all day they could use their hands and still, you know, tend to their occupation. I think I'm gonna break something. Oh! Okay, this is ringing here. I would get a phone call from someone and I'd be like, yeah, I got you. Number 35 wants to talk to you. Interested? With the introduction of the switchboard, it was now possible for the Bell operator to manually connect many telephone subscribers. At the time, terms of courtesy weren't quite up to today's standards. Until 1895, switchboard operators would say, what do you want? Or, are you there? Until the greeting, number please, was suggested.
An extension phone in your kitchen. It's so wonderful in every way.
Order yours in color, wall type or regular. Call your Bell telephone business office.
We looked at the magneto before. This is like version on steroids. It's like, remember playing Tetris back in the day? Like level one was easy, right? That was the magneto. This is when stuff just starts falling really, really fast and you try to connect people and then you lose. Or hopefully, well, you connect everyone, which is what happened. In the 20s, service was provided by an army of switchboard operators. At the time, some operators working in large telephone exchanges went so far as to wear roller skates in order to distribute messages to other staff members.
Elmer, go answer the phone.
That's why Elmer got an extension phone for his bedroom. So can you, at your Bell telephone business office.
This over here is pretty impressive. This is actually called a step-by-step. I got the number of my homie over there. 4, 5, 8. And I'd be like, phone is ringing! Yellow? Who is it? It's Patrick. I just got life insurance. It's Patrick. He just got life insurance. The automatic switching system enabled people to make their own calls without having to go through an operator. This new system coincided with the arrival of the rotary dial phone. Okay then, who's up for tracking down one of the oldest things that we have here? We can do that, right? Show them the archives?
Yes.
Amazing. Follow me.